President Obama has declared a national swine flu emergency, and it looks like Capmark Financial, the commercial real estate giant, may be filing for bankruptcy. Hello, it's October 25th, 2009. I'm Demcat, also known as Reginald, first Capmark Financial. It used to be a lending arm of GMAC, and now it looks like they may be filing for bankruptcy. And it looks like it may come pretty soon. It may even come as early as this week, actually. They reported a second quarter loss of $1.6 billion. Also, Obama's declaring a national swine flu emergency. So far, it's been about 11.3 million doses of the vaccine that's been shipped out to U.S. doctors and hospitals and nurses and whatnot. Interesting enough, the first daughters have not been vaccinated against the H1N1 vaccine. And like I said, like I reported before, the Secretary of Health and Human Services gave immunity to the producers of this vaccine. So essentially, if something goes wrong and you take this vaccine, there's really no way you can sue the producers of this vaccine. So again, I just want to highlight that point. And like I said, it's been a national emergency declared because of this. Well-known Chicago Bar mothers apparently is being accused of racism. Six black men from colleges, college students, they were from St. Louis. They were in Chicago, and they went to this bar, and the manager told them that their jeans were too baggy. And then one of the black students, switched jeans with a white student, and the white student with the baggy jeans was permitted into the bar. So basically, they are considering filing a lawsuit because they felt like they were discriminated against. And based on the article, it looks like they're absolutely correct. It's interesting because when I think about any type of claim of racism, I think about what some of the politicians did, some of the Democrats did when they claimed that people were being racist because they didn't support Barack Obama or because they were opposing Barack Obama. And like I said, it's like the boy who cried wolf. Because politicians are using the race car as a weapon to fight their opponents, it could have really negative consequences for people who really are victims of racism. And this is an example of how people could just say, oh, well, these guys are just playing a race card. But it looks like they really are victims of racism. And it's one of the reasons why you need to be careful with the word racism, throwing that around. Anyway, twin Baghdad blasts kill over 100 people. Actually, killed at least 132 people in Iraq and, well, in Baghdad. And it injured over 520 people. Two car bombs. Those are pretty massive numbers right there. Home sales rise 9.4% in September. Basically, home resales in September's clocked the largest monthly increase in 26 years. Buyers were scrambling to buy up houses before the tax credit ran out. And basically, there's a tax credit if you're a new homeowner. You get money, some additional money for going out and buying a house. So a lot of people took advantage of that. And I'm not going to say it's a good idea or a bad idea, but I would hold off on buying any type of real estate because I think the banks are hiding a lot of their bad assets. I think they're hiding a lot of foreclosures. They're not calling people who should be deep into the process. And I think once all these houses hit the market, then the price of houses are going to decrease dramatically. I told you guys in my last video what was going on with the housing prices. So, hey, question of the day. Was there ever an instance where you felt like you were being discriminated because of your race or because of your gender or because of your sexual orientation? Please let me know. I don't care what your background is. Tell me if you felt like you were discriminated against. I'd love to hear your stories. I mean, not like I like hearing that stuff. It's just I like sharing ideas with people. Anyway, guys, if you have any comments about anything, feel free to comment. Don't forget to rate the video. I hope you guys have a good day. Bye.